So now we're on page 182, and we're going to fill at the top. And I need you to write this at the top of your page. Y equals A, and then I'm going to write the word trig function, because it's going to apply to any trig function. Open parenthesis, B, and then a parenthesis, X, minus C, plus D. This is kind of the basic transformation. And we wrote trig function here because it's applying to sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, cosecant. A right here is the amplitude. And it's quote unquote on the outside of the trig function, which makes it a boy thing. So it applies to all the y values. It's the amplitude. It's the vertical stretch. So it says, when is A a stretch? A is a stretch when the absolute value of A is bigger than 1. And it's a shrink when the absolute value of A is less than 1. And then it says, what happens if A is negative? Well, if you have any function that you're used to and you put a negative out front, you've made all the y stuff negative, which means it's a reflection across the x-axis. Okay, and now we're going to graph the following. And these are very simplistic ones to graph, but we're going to do the same thing every single time we graph so that we never mess up, no matter how hard the trig function is. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to make a big old table. And in the first column of the table, we're going to put theta. And in this far column of the table, we need to look at the trig function. So since we're graphing sine, we need the y part of the ordered pairs. And when we graphed on the previous page, we went around the circle. And we used this angle, and this angle, and this angle, and this angle, and then this angle again. So we're going to use 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and then 2 pi. And now I'm going to write down on the parent function what sine was, or what the y-coordinate was at these angles. So if you go around the circle, at 0, sine is 0. At pi over 2, sine is 1. At pi, sine is 0. At 3 pi over 2, it's negative 1. And at 2 pi, it is 0 again. So that's how you're going to start every trig graphing problem. Now we're going to go back to the problem up top. And we are going to graph based on what the transformation is.